So now we're at the point in this expansion where we're looking for weird little disparate locations with hidden away quests from place to place. No notice boards are going to tell me how to find these spots. You just have to visit all these little ruins I haven't quite gotten around to yet.
Give me peace, peace. What makes you insist on me as your victim? Why choose me to torment? Begone, foul spirit.
You're tormented. By what?
Forgive me, but I must ask directly. Are you a man? I no longer trust my senses.
Yes, meaning I'm physical, no specter or vision, if that's what you fear. Don't trust your senses? Why?
A foulness, a demon or wraith haunts me, grants me no rest. It wants something. I sense this, but know not what. Each day it appears, tarries, then leaves. It's here now, there, beyond the trees.
Don't see a thing.
Of course not. It cannot be seen.
Yet you see it?
Only when I drink the brew, which brings a pain to my head, nausea. But I endure these to keep an eye on the wraith, my tormentor.
This demon of yours, can you describe it?
It is an enormous horse. Its hoofbeats pounding in the dark. It gallops to me, stops, stares, then runs on.
Sure it's not just a wild horse, run-of-the-mill?
The creature is not of this world. When it gazes at me, a terrible chill pervades my soul. It is evil condensed. Its eyes black, void. Each time it comes, terror grips me. I cease what I'm doing. Still my breath and heart.
What's your brew made of? Gotta wonder what's causing such strong visions. You drop in some mushroom, jumper tub, dancing dewlap?
Close. The common greytop. I see you know your herbs.
Greytop? Variety's extinct if I recall correctly.
Nearly, but not quite. I was able to grow a few from dried spores. I'd hoped a brew of Greytop would reveal this nightmare. I was not wrong.
Far as I know, Greytop produces some powerful side effects. Though it can, in fact, reveal the hidden, the immaterial.
Yes, I see the evil. Better that than to know it is there, but not know where.
Fine. You seem sure something's out there. I'll see what I can do. Start by taking a look around.
Ghost horse! Ooh, equine phantoms. Yep, that's another word for that, I guess. If you want to commit to that. Hello?
Dead moths. Attracted to some ghosts like to the light of a candle.
There's some additional evidence.
Seems there's at least some truth to the hermit's ravings.
Anything inside? Hello? The Flagellant's Manifesto. Yep. Probably is why she's wearing that monk-like garb and has those what looks like whips hanging over her shoulders. Fellow sons and daughters of Lebioda, the end is nigh. Mend your ways and put your faith in the good tome, for our prophet has written to shun the pleasures of the flesh and shirk from comfort is at times recommended, and to value one's neighbor's fortune above one's own comfort is commendable. That is why we, the Eighth Day Flagellants, scourge ourselves and torment our flesh to ensure all folk of the world enjoy long and prosperous lives. Whatever evil, sickness, or misconduct lurks in the world's darkest corners survives not because we have been negligent in striking our backs with the whip. Alright, they're crazy.
If we beat ourselves, the evil will go away.
Drops of blood on the pillow. Trail of them leading to the window.
Oh, window blood, you say? Oh, yep. That's trail to follow. Interesting.
Shutters closed tight. Need to check the other side, see if the trail continues.
That'd be almost weird if it didn't. What's up with this?
Common Greytop. Strong hallucinogen. Thought extinct. Don't often get to see that.
So there are hallucinogenic mushrooms around here. Good to know. How do I find those? See, this is the shutter. More moths. How about this path, though? It goes off for a while.
Trail of blood starts at the pillow, ends here. Medallion's still vibrating. Something drinks the hermit's blood at night. That I know. Gotta talk to her. Maybe she can tell me something more.
Do we have a vampire horse? Is that where we're going with this? Also, what's that sound? Oh, it's a wolfie. Are you friendly? Oh, dogs and wolves having it out a little bit? They're just grouped together. This wolf doesn't have a name, though. Oh, look at this. Ha! Look at this bitchy little cat trying to defend its territory. You are the size of a foot and weigh half as much.
Witcher.
Heard flagellants whip themselves to atone for all humankind's wrongs. To appease the gods, gain their forgiveness. That why you do it?
We've each our own reasons. I seek to atone for the suffering of a living being, which once fell victim to another's vanity. I care not for humankind, preferring instead the company of animals.
Most likely some kind of wraiths tormenting you. Can't tell what kind, though. Felt weak, spent lately? Notice bite marks on your skin?
As I said, I feel weaker by the day. And bites, of course. There are lice and midges here aplenty.
This isn't lice. Something much bigger drinks your blood while you sleep.
But I do not sleep. Not a wink. He's always present. Always watching. I cannot bear it any longer.
Sadly, not much I can do. Can't exterminate it if I can't see it.
The Greytop. I shall make a brew of it for you. I've 2 mushrooms left. Enough for 1 dose. Perhaps then you'll see what I do.
This mushroom, even in me, could produce some nasty, unpredictable side effects.
True. There is no knowing how Greytop would affect a mutated body.
I'm just kind of thinking, like, if I'm going to take a hallucinogenic, maybe she should leave the area in case I hallucinate her into being something I'm supposed to exterminate.
A proper brew could be our only chance to figure this out.
This is the kind of thing where, this is like the definition of why I don't like doing anything that's mind-altering in general, because it bothers me, the idea of losing access to your senses and everything. But you kind of give up on that concept if you're playing Witcher, because you are a Witcher, and one of their specialties is mind and body altering toxins and potions and brews, so this isn't that far outside of his wheelhouse, even though we don't know what it's going to do.
All right, high time we tried this. If I start muttering something about unicorns or sorceresses, ignore it.
Reference game on point. He'll be fine, folks. credits aren't rolling yet. Snake? Snake! That's a horse, but not the right horse. That's just my horse. Well, everything's wavy now.
Don't see no wraith.
Wow, this clover's amazing. Now that's what I call a bouquet.
Who said that?
Oh, you're awake. Had me worried. You were out way too long. Even considered giving you some white honey. Kinda hard to do with hooves, though.
Roach?
Unusual sounding. It's really unusual to have someone sounding American in this game, but also, aren't you supposed to be female?
Your voice. It's, interesting. Gotta say, I expected a young mare to sound. Girlish.
Based on what? Your vast experience with talking animals? Far as I know, I'm your first.
Good point.
Alright, I'm talking to my horse. I guess this was inevitable. This is the, this is that big, like, we've been doing these characters for a super long time, and we're getting ready to goodbye, we're getting ready to say goodbye to them, finally. Let's have the Doctor talk to his TARDIS in human form for once.
Must be the brew that did this. Interesting side effect.
Great, isn't it? You should take this stuff more often. Got so many pointers I could give you.
Can't, sadly. Drinking this too often could prove fatal. Hey, know how you always show up when I whistle? How's that work exactly?
Well, you're my human. Gotta be there when you need me. Yes, I'll be there for you, as the world falls down.
Still kinda strange. And you cross the ocean when I call sometimes, but then get hung up on the tiniest fence. What's that about?
What can I say? Everyone's got limits.
Wow. They're actually making jokes about how bad the horse riding is and the way that he magically teleports around.
Listen, got this contract I need to finish before the brew wears off.
Right. Monster won't slay itself. Let me see. First up, I need to know what we're dealing with. Follow me, and try not to trample any plants or small animals.
Is this us changing roles? He's talking to me like I'm the horse now. Alright.
Geralt, we gotta inspect this area closely. I'll look for clues. You stand there and... well, just stand.
Right.
Yep, this is a role reversal, absolutely. Also... we have an update here, alright? Let's see. Wow. Is this a brand new update? I think this might be brand new. I'm not sure if this was even here before. Roach. A horse is more to a witcher than merely a means of locomotion. Just ask any bandit who has taken a well-aimed hoof to the head during combat. Additionally, many a witcher has talked over the nuts and bolts of his current contract with his horse while staring at the stars shining above the lonely road, though few would ever admit to this. Geralt named every mount Roach, though no one really knows why or what Geralt had in mind with his name. When asked, Geralt would dodge the question or give an evasive answer. Perhaps this had just been the first word that came to his head? Roach, for her part, seemed to accept the name with no reservations. Geralt would grow annoyed and curse whenever Roach panicked and tossed him in the middle of battle, as well as when she would suddenly turn a different direction when he wanted than he wanted while he was riding at full gallop towards some urgent destination. In truth, though, he was very attached to her and would never trade her for any other horse. Not even one which, when summoned, would never stand helpless in front of a seemingly easily surmountable obstacle, such as a low fence or a stray piece of timber. Nor even one which would sometimes, in some incomprehensible fashion, wind up dancing on some peasant's roof. Well, Geralt would say, with a shrug, a witch's horse isn't a normal animal. Constant contact with magic beverages and science must have left a mark. Wow. the glossary is that just acknowledging, like, horse glitches now.
Look at that.
We're several layers into meta commentary at this point. I'm helping
Mike. See anything here?
These are hoof prints. Not just any old horses either. These were left by an astral being, otherworldly. We gotta follow them.
I'm helping my horse on a Witcher investigation.
Geralt, look! This here's definitely a clue!
The one I already saw?
Dead moths often mean a phantom's nearby.
Thanks, Captain Obvious. Now, what about the smell? Same whiff I caught at the cemetery in Vizima when we were hunting ghouls.
The smell of death!
Smells normal to me. Not taking me for a ride, are you?
Seriously?
I am going to milk out all the horse puns I can, because now I'm, for the first time, I can hear you groan.
All right. Now I know what we're up against.
Right, Geralt. Let's sum up what we know so far.
No one's going to believe me after this, including me.
We're dealing with some kind of wraith or phantom, most likely. It visits the hermit at night, drinks her blood. Even if we manage to find it, I've got no idea how I could possibly fight it.
Geralt, please, I got this. It's definitely an Umbra, an immaterial wraith. This one's assumed the form of a horse.
An Umbra actually makes sense. Umbra are completely invisible, even to witchers. But how can you be sure?
Because it's not invisible to me, doofus. It's right over there. Come on, Witcher, hop in the saddle! Gotta catch it!
My horse just called me a doofus. My horse. Which solved... My horse both solved a... It solved the riddle and called me a doofus. I have so many questions. Also, what is an Umbra, among other things? Spectre, obviously Spectre oil, of course, but also what else? According to some philosophers, everything we do in life leaves a permanent trace in the delicate matter which makes up our souls. Evil deeds, especially harm done to innocent creatures, can torment the soul of a sinner and cause it to remain restless even after death. While traveling through Toussaint, Geralt discovered there might be a grain of truth to these theories and folk beliefs. He came across a hermit whose sleep was troubled by some invisible phantom, obviously Spectre Oil, and takes the form of a color-inverted Rapidash. Where's that Spectre Oil? It all looks the same to me. I could play this game for hundreds of hours and never memorize which of these icons is which oil.
Hey! Gotta save my strength a bit! No telling how long we're gonna need to keep running!
Now he's getting on me for the stamina usage, isn't he? How about this? What if I...
We gotta have a man-to-horse talk. No offense, but your riding skills, they leave a bit to be desired, buddy.
Quiet. I have a bow. It's not really working out right now.
Really do me a solid if you could apply a slightly surer hand. Be a little more decisive about where you want me to go. Sometimes I got no idea, buddy. Do I go left, right, toward where I'm standing?
Yeah, and it'd be great if you could respond more fluidly to my commands.
Hey, heard this one? Horse walks into a tavern, and the innkeeper says, "Hey,
that's
pal, why the long face?"
Four. All right.
Let's not lose sight of that Umbra. Can you see it now?
Yeah, I'm trying.
Yeah, it's right there. Run, Roach.
What the fuck do you think I'm doing?
Roach said twerk. We're gonna have to accept that for now. I don't think this works. I think I just have to chase it forever. Not gonna get any auto-targeting here. Alright.
As long as we're being candid, I gotta ask. Why do you sometimes buck me off in the middle of a fight?
First I've heard. Don't recall that ever happening.
Of course you don't.
This is perfectly written. How is this a side quest?
Melted into thin air!
Okay. Where you at? Oh, okay. Whoa! That's Quinn. That's not Irden. Apparitions!
Which were the overgrown demon cats? Help!
Oh, try slow whole zone down. Alright. So I want to point out that they hired a voice actor to or they might have been an existing voice actor for the game, but they got a voice actor to play Roach, and they created this combat scenario, the unique asset of the flaming ghost horse, and all this other nonsense going on here, all to put in a side quest, not just a side quest, but a side quest that wasn't even you couldn't even find it via a notice board. You had to just wander into the right little tiny village, not even a village, it's one house off the road in the middle of nowhere that you have no reason to go to besides just going there. That's insane. CD Projekt Red, you are insane, people. I don't understand how you're in business. Now, I don't know if they're even getting slowed down, to be honest. I'm gonna keep myself going for as long as I can here. Ow, dodged into you instead of away from you. Oh, my echidna decoction's not on. That would help. No, come back over here into my slow zone. Come on. It loves you. There we go. Feel the pain. Where'd you go? Oh. Alright. Reapply Quinn. Are we starting over? Let's pop some Irdens down again while I wait for you to do a prayer! Okay. Whoa! Hello. Surprise apparition. Burn. Okay. Being a little teamed up on right now. Watch out. Watch out. How much longer till you just go down on your own? Uh-oh. About to go down. About to go down myself. Quinn? My, Irdens are staying up so far, but they're probably about to go down. Oh! Ow. Don't think my Irdens that effective, even though they're both land-based enemies and apparitions. Or they're, oh yeah, they're right. They're called apparitions, not, well, an apparition's still a ghost, right? Because if it's a ghost, it's the whole point is supposed to be that it's vulnerable against Irden, usually. There's a lot of butterflies around, too, which tend to show up around apparitions and whatnot. Oh wait, moths. We've been over this, Geralt. By which I mean me. What are you doing? Where are you going? Ow. Pain. We good? That was just a sword. Anything else?
Marcello Clerici, knight, died last year. Was more or less the same age as our hermit. Seems his spirit's become a horse-shaped umbra that's tormenting Panastri.
Why are you telling me this? I can read and draw my own conclusions.
Thinking aloud, that's all, helps me focus.
Geralt! It's the Umbra! Attack!
Let me explain!
Talk, but make it fast. Why are you tormenting the hermit?
She torments me! Refuses to forgive me! I'm denied peace in the afterlife, and it's all her doing! Each day I come and beg her for clemency.
Beg her for clemency? You drink her blood, drive her mad with fear.
I don't know how to explain it, but yes, the monstrous force takes me. Though I also know I'll not have peace till the day Panastri forgives me.
You and the hermit, how do you know each other?
We met as babes, grew up side by side. I I loved her. Yet she was always sad. Nothing could cheer her. The world terrified her. I thought her gloom came from being poor. So I did my damnedest to take us from our village, make us a better life elsewhere. Became a squire, took her with me to the palace. But Panastri soon learned nobles are no more decent than peasants, not a speck. Once even I'd grown vile to her eyes, she fled the palace and joined the flagellants. I left the court to be near her, yet she cast me off, said she didn't want to know me. When the whip-bearers proved too hard-hearted for her too, she became a hermit. I see it clearly now, though I never understood her while alive. From the grave's dark depth, the living are bright, sharp flares. You see all their thoughts at once. Now I understand why she had to cast me off.
She's full of rage. Probably what turned you into an Umbra.
So it sounds like she accidentally cast a spell on him just from her constant anger and self-harm or whatever's going on here. Whoa! My glasses lenses are flying out of their lenses because it's apparent this distortion effect has a specific effect on exactly however the hell the glass effect is handled by this game. That is freaky look at. Okay.
Why take the form of a horse?
A horse? What do you mean? Each day since I died, a power lifts me from my grave and makes me run. Then I return with blood in my mouth. I don't know what this is, how it comes to pass, but I do know the torment will continue until she forgives me. But she sees me as a horse, you say?
Seems so. Same way I saw you. Must have hurt her something awful if she refuses to forgive you, would rather see you suffer. What did you do?
To her? Nothing. But my horse, I have flogged it to death. Pinastri, she saw this. A proud stallion, my blaze. But he was a bucker, and tossed me during a tourney. One I'd wanted to win badly. Pinastri had been so glad they'd let me stand. Me, a peasant's son. I wanted to win it for her. But that horse made me lose. Rage overcame me. I struck and struck until at last he fell. Oh, the regret! I beg you, forgive me. Absolve me in Blaze's very name.
Can't forgive you for that. Not in my power.
But your horse could? Please, I'd do anything. I'm desperate. Help me. Noble mare, forgive me my sin.
Could free his spirit, pardoning him on behalf of his horse. But you shouldn't do it if you don't think he deserves forgiveness.
Did a rotten thing. Got no excuse. Your horse was loyal. Did the best damn job he could. That's how we horses are.
True. I know I deserved what befell me.
But we aren't vengeful, don't hold grudges, don't dwell on being left in monster-infested woods. So, in your poor Blaze's name, I forgive you.
Oh, thank you. I feel it's incredible. Such relief, such lightness.
All right, then. Guess we might as well head back. Panastri's knights ought to be ghost-free from now on. Anything to add, Geralt?
Nope. Let's go see her.
I think I'm gonna miss having Roach talk all the time. This whole thing could have like a whole like buddy cop thing going on if there was somebody to talk to. I kind of love how his voice doesn't fit with anything else in this game.
Phantom's gone. Shouldn't torment you ever again.
I felt a change. I did. As if I'd been released from a cramped dunk cellar. I had come to believe no one could help me. I'm grateful, Witcher. I'm well aware Witchers work for hire, for pay. But I've no coin, alas. I can offer only this.
Potatoes.
A good crop this year. Exceptional.
Oughta thank my horse, actually. Phantom's departure, mostly Roach's doing.
Then I thank you too, noble creature.
Gotta admit, easy peasy with our powers combined. So, what now? We hit the path? Ride to the nearest notice board? Rustle up another contract?
Exactly. Though, effects of the bruise waning, I can feel it. Won't be able to understand you soon.
That's horseshit. I mean, I got so much more I want to tell you, and...
Clever beasts, horses. Farewell, Witcher.
Well, I don't know how anything else we do could do anything besides pale compared to that, huh? We actually got an update on our character log for Roach again, too. Hey, it's Barnabas. Geralt could not have hoped for better help. One could even say that, by entrusting Corvo Bianco to the hands of that marvelous majordomo, Anna Henrietta had given the Witcher the most beautiful present he'd ever received. For a home without someone capable to care for it is no home at all. Where are you? You were on top of the list last time. Why did you move? Alright, Roach. Wow, there's so many things in this game. So many. Wait. I went past it again. I probably wasn't past it yet. Oh, there it is. While completing a contract in Toussaint, Geralt had the chance to find out exactly how serious Roach took her role, and how well versed in the area of the Witcher's trade she was. He also discovered she was an entirely pleasant conversation partner. Aww. Now we'll never talk to her again. Farewell, Roach voice actor.